Hey guys, I'm finally able to bring you in the flesh the house that we've been designing and constructing for months. It's going to be in-house down at the Solar Decathlon competition. Went down there and I'm just happy to share it with you. We're going to be giving you a VIP tour of the house as we move around. Keep an eye on this screen on the exterior, the wooden slats that were initially designed to give the house its shading components, and it does that, but the architects took that a step further, integrated in such a way that it has an awesome texture to the house, and especially when you look at the house through this view, which is where the entrance is going to be, it kind of blends into the house itself, varying densities, plays into this whole idea here where you get a cross section into the house and you can see all three layers of the house coming together, the shading, the passive elements, all just mixed with a marvelous front entrance. So they did an amazing job and it was just stunning when I finally saw this in person. As you start to wrap around, you see the little details like the gutters that then feed the water into the surrounding planter boxes. You get to take a look at where our unofficial garage is going to be, where we just park this BMW, I believe it's the i3, the electric vehicle, which you have to use for the competition. You have to power it and do some mileage with it. And then you also get to see again how the core works with the huge central mechanical block in the center, and you could see different components attached to the outside. Well tank and a pressure system to provide domestic plumbing pressure, and then you get to see the backside of our constructed wetlands. Then I start to peek over at the rear of the house, but we'll get to that soon. Next, I'm going to walk you through the booth. Kind of this is where you go as you first visit the house. A lot of information and then some examples of the bifacial panels we're using, as well as the phase change material here encapsulated in a little sheet. It's now currently in liquid form, but if you were to come back later in the evening or in the morning, it would be crystallized, giving you a sneak peek of the bifacial room, which is perhaps my favorite area of the house, with the panels providing electricity but also shading the area, so you get a nice cool, comfortable deck. And again, like I said, we'll get back to that. Now this is going to be the main tour route, so all along the way, if you were taking this tour, you'd have people explaining to you the concept behind the house. And now we're moving up to the front entrance itself, which I've already talked about how I'm so happy about it. You see the planter boxes right through there with the plants, the gutters, and then you see how we have the clerestory windows up through there, the little windows into the house providing lighting, and then we have our nice smiling tour guide who's going to let us in for a private tour. I'm going to walk you through here, and as you enter in, you can see just how jaw-droppingly awesome this is. And I don't say that because of my personal biases. I think it's just, you know, beautiful what the architects accomplished. So job well done to them. And it's just one thing to design this in paper, and it's another to see it in real life, especially all the stuff we did, like designing windows to be in the corner to bring further lighting into the house. You can see just how stunningly that does work out in real life. So I was very happy to see everything that was conceptual finally work out to be in reality. The laminate floors look great, the kitchen island better than I could have ever expected, the integration of all the appliances that we chose into the kitchen looks marvelous. Up top again, the clerestory windows looking great with the canted wall section right there to bounce light into the house to make it even brighter. That's so much more visible than I would have ever imagined, especially in the bathroom, where you consider in here that there are no lights, no eye level windows, and yet it's still perfectly illuminated from above. We have this awesome shower. The finishes everywhere is great. The white, just impeccable. It's a beautiful house that I would definitely like to live in. And I'm so happy with how it came out. Now here's the master bedroom. Again, this is all like finely detailed, and I had never expected to see this. You get to see more of the windows looking out. You get all these stunning views from within the bedroom. Oh God, I can't get over this. And then you have these little monitors all over the place to measure the temperature and the performance of the house. The decoration was done well. The cabinetry is awesome. Here is one of the views seen out from the bedroom, and you can notice where I'm standing. I'm in the shade. That's because the house itself provides views, but is also shaded. Then we have a Murphy bed that turns into also a desk over there, so that's awesome. And now we're going to continue out here. Like I said, the mechanical room above my head right now currently is shading the master bedroom window, so you get the views but none of the heat, which is awesome. Then out here in the deck with the awesome redwood finish, a nice comfortable lounge chair where you can hang out, you get a view of the other houses. And then finally the bifacial room here with the panels up above. This was, like I said, my favorite area of the house. So I hope you guys enjoyed this tour. I hope you like the progression from design to construction all the way through to the final presentation. There's so much to this house, and we're going to be going through the competition. Fingers crossed, we hope to do well. But anyways, I will leave links in the description below where you can check out more about this house. I hope you've enjoyed this entire presentation. I definitely enjoyed the process, and it's something I would recommend to anyone who's even slightly interested in this. Keep an eye out for Solar Decathlons in the future. Hopefully you can participate not only as someone who would attend and support the event, but perhaps even participate in it. I know a lot of you are in college or in high school and are looking to see if you want to do this kind of stuff. I can tell you from personal experience, it is just one of the most awesome things you can do. I can't recommend this enough. Anyways, thanks so much for following along in this epic journey. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll be answering questions in the comments below. See you guys in the next one. Peace out.